going to adjust your posture and keep you upright and give you a lot more space for your baby and a lot more space for you to breathe properly. So this is really good, particularly when you come into the third trimester and the baby is taking a lot of room and is up in your diaphragm a lot. You might find it quite difficult to do it first, but as you progress with this exercise, you find the more that you do it, the better activation your back is and the better you're going to feel. So I want you to find a wall or a mirror to come against, and I want you to pop your heels against the mirror, your bottom rest against it, and I want you to engage the top of your shoulders and the back of your head. Make a double chin, so just make sure your chin is tucked down. And from here, we're going to bring our arms up to shoulder height. Make sure your pelvis is engaged, squeeze the bottom as hard as you can, and then draw the tummy back to engage the transverse abdominis. From here, we inhale as we take the arms up. And I want you to go nice and slow, because I want you to try and keep your elbows engaged and touching the mirror. You probably won't be able to do this first of all, but the more you practice it, the better you'll find it. And then as you come down and exhale, you really want to be pressing those elbows back into the mirror all the way. Now personally, I can't get my elbows to touch the mirror all the way because obviously I'm postnatal as well, and I've spent so much time on computer this year and carrying my baby and bags to and from the car and things, so my shoulders aren't as good as they should be. Okay, so exhale on the way down, and you want to do between sort of 10 and 20 repetitions on this. We're trying to get the muscles to fire properly, and we want to engage them in long-term activity rather than just building strength for short periods of time. So we're using a bigger repetition range here. So inhale, exhale down. So I think this is 3 for me. And I'm taking it back 3 seconds for each one. So 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. What you'll probably find as you're doing this is you feel very tight in your neck and your upper back. And you find it really hard to push those elbows back. And that's because your chest muscles will have shortened and tightened up from the extra weight that you're carrying in front and also from pregnancy posture. So all this work to correct it will feel like it's a little bit uncomfortable for you. You might feel some strain through your neck. If it gets too intense, of course, please just stop. Or just go within the range where you find you can do it without it hurting you. You don't want to cause pain in it. And if you get achy, then stop. Okay, I'm starting to ache quite a lot there, that's about 8 repetitions for me. So I'm going to stop there, take a rest, and then I want you to carry on for 4 sets. So again, we're doing a lot of sets for this, but I want you to learn this movement, and what you need to learn the movement and embed it into your spinal cord is volume. So volume is about repetitions and amount of sets. That's a really good one to do after your warm-up and before you start your workout, particularly a back workout, to make sure that all muscles are firing properly and you're going to use them properly when it comes to your workout. Okay, so that's it for today. I'll see you in next week's coaching video. And yeah, have a good week. And of course, if you want to get all of these videos and you can't remember where you saw last one, if you lost an email, go to my YouTube channel. They're all there. www.youtube.com/NishaCoach, or come and have a look in the